Good morning, Park Hill Christian Church. How's everybody doing this morning? It's 11 o'clock in the morning instead of 9 o'clock in the morning, so I expect a little bit more enthusiasm. How's everybody doing this morning? That's what I'm talking about. You're awake. We are ready for lunch. No, it is Youth Sunday, and we are super excited to have Youth Sunday here. We got all these lovely people in green today, including several lovely young singers here singing with us this morning. If you will, please stand and sing and worship with us together. You are holy.
You are holy.
You are mighty.
You are mighty.
You are worthy.
You are worthy.
Worthy of praise.
Worthy of praise.
I will follow. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You may be seated.
Welcome each and every one of you to our church service, and a very warm welcome for those of you attending for the first time. Whether you're just passing by looking for a loving place to worship, we take this time to welcome you in a wonderful way. We are a body of Christ, and we love everyone, whether it's your first time or second time. Our goal here is to love one another so that the joy of the Lord may be full in our hearts. Our annual church picnic will take place at the Sherwood Forest after the service. Please bring sides and desserts to go along with hamburgers and hot dogs that will be provided. Youth began meeting on the second and fourth Wednesday night at 5:30. We will continue meeting throughout the summer. If you are able to provide a snack supper for 10 to 15 people, please speak to Sarah Clemens or Susan Hanford. We want to encourage everyone to fill out the red church attendance book, the red folder, located in your row. Just write your names and email addresses because we would love to get in touch with you. Please say hello to your neighbor as we sing our next song. If you brought a donation for our mission trip, there is a table in the back.
Coming deserve it till you give yourself away.
Prepare for our mission trip to Bainbridge, Georgia. We will teach Bible lessons with foster kids and help around the facilities. Also remember all those on our prayer list found in the bulletin. We would also like to recognize Jordan Jackson for being Student of the Year. Our own Catherine McLean will be 100 tomorrow.
Please pray with us. Father, thank you that you have brought each of us safely to this place. We gladly surrender our lives to you in worship and praise. As we gather, we remember those who are not with us today. Those who are sick, we ask for healing. And for those away from us, we ask for your blessing to be on them. Come dwell in each of our hearts, equip us, comfort us, teach us. Inspire us as we learn more about you. We ask all of this in the wonderful name of Jesus. Amen.
All children, please come up here.
Come on, children.
Good morning. I got a question for y'all. Have any of you ever been scared of monsters that are under your bed? Until now? It's okay if you have or you haven't. Everyone gets scared of something. Maybe it's spiders or snakes or bugs. Whatever you're scared of, God will protect you.
In John 1:15, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
In Psalm 27:1, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is my strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?
If you've ever gotten scared, raise your hand. We all get scared sometimes. But we have to remember that Jesus is the light, and he will guide us through. He told his disciples to spread his light because back in Jesus' time, they lived in small houses and didn't have lights in their homes. So they had to trust Jesus' light.
We still trust for Jesus to be the light and guide us through all of our troubles. We give you this light to remind you that Jesus is your light in the dark. We might not be able to feel him or see him, but we know that he is there to guide us.
Please pray with us. Dear God, thank you for sending your son to be the light during our darkest times. We know you will guide us through each day. Please keep these children safe through the last week of school. Thank you for all you have done for us. Amen.
Please don't leave. We have something to give y'all. And you are going to have your time, but whenever it is then, do not shine it in people's eyes.
Thank you.
Deuteronomy 31:8. The Lord himself goes before you and will be with you. He will never leave you. He will nor forsake you. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. This scripture is one we should all probably memorize because it is so important. Is there really anything that you should be afraid of when you have God with you, with us? It is almost like God knows that we will struggle with fear. He reminds us that he is with us, and he tells us to not fear. Why? Because God is with us. Say it with me. God is with us. And not only that, he will strengthen us as if his presence with us is not enough. He also gives us strength. God knows that we will be afraid over and over. In Scripture are these reminders. Do not be afraid. Do not fear. So think about the situation that causes you to fear. Now picture you're facing those situations with God, because that is reality. You do not face those things alone.
Let your fire fall, your love is all I feel.
Not wanted. Self-image. Worthless. Insignificant. These things do not fear. God is with us. Even those people who live in real fear every single day, God promises truth for them also. God is greater than all of our fears.
Isaiah 41:9-10. I took you from places far away on the earth and called you from a faraway country. I said, you are my servants. I have chosen you and have not turned against you. So do not worry because I am with you. Do not be afraid because I am your God. I will make you strong and I will help you. I will support you with my right hand that saves you. And he can and will give us strength to face those fears. Please pray with me. Heavenly Father, we come to you today with fear and worry on our hearts. Help us to cast all our fears to you and trust that you are greater than any fear we may have. Please go with each other, each and every one of us today. Give us strength to face all of our fears through you. We ask these things in your Son's name. Amen.
Thank you.
kinds of things can go wrong in our lives, and try as we may, there's nothing we can do on our own to set things right. That's why we need to disconnect from the world sometimes to come into the presence of God to help us set things right.
Please know that all are invited and welcome at this table. As you come, disconnect from the world for a moment and focus on our Lord. Listen to him say, "Do this in remembrance of me," and let him do his work in your life.
Please pray with me. Dear God, today we gather as brothers and sisters in Christ to remember the extraordinary sacrifice you made in sending Jesus, your beloved Son, to be with us. We thank you for his legacy in words, actions, and obedience to suffering on the cross. Lord, we come to you now to ask for forgiveness for any thoughts, words, or deeds that have not honored your name. We are also truly sorry for the times we have chosen to live selfishly rather than heed your calling. We invite you to live in our hearts now as we take communion. As we share this meal, come bind us together as one family, filled with your love. Amen.
The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
In the same way, he took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you drink this, as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you will proclaim the Lord's death until he comes again."
Pray for us as we prepare for our mission trip to Bainbridge, Georgia. We will work with foster kids through the West Haven. As we end, if you'd like to speak to Pastor Joe, he will be here during our next song.
Just because of its significance, and because my 60-year-old ears didn't hear all of it, Catherine, where are you? Stand up for us. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Ladies and gentlemen, 100 years old tomorrow. Catherine McClay. You know, if you're going to make a mistake, make a big one. And if you're going to make a mistake, do it with confidence. But I have no fear. Okay. Well, that's one way to get a worship service from serious to... Thank you. Yeah. Thank you to all of our youth. Thank you to all of our youth sponsors. Thank you to Sarah and Susan. Thank you to Stephen. Thank you to everyone who had a part of this lovely, lovely day. After we pray, we'll sing a song, and then we'll have a congregational meeting that Danny will come and lead us in. And we ask all of you to stay for this short but important meeting, if you would. Would you pray with me? Our God, it's the 27th Psalm that says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is my stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I fear?" Oh God, fear is a dark shadow that can envelop us and utterly imprison us within ourselves at times. But oh God, that you have come to live inside, to walk among us, to take our hands, to envelop your arms around us all, and put precious church family members to love on us, even in times of fear or unknown. Thank you for the way that you love us. Thank you for the way that we love each other. And it's in Jesus' name we pray today. Amen. Happy birthday.
As we close our service, we would like to invite all the children to bring their flashlights and join us in front of the stage for a closing song.
Tears and joy.